Welcome to the Fireside Chat, Season 2, Episode 2, on the air. JB, hard act to follow last week, but I think I managed to do it. I managed to top them this week, coming into the CCPE Lounge and Studios here in lovely Las Vegas. I have the handler of arguably, if you haven't been following him on Twitter and you haven't seen his work over in the XWF, you're missing out. This gentleman got back into the game probably about 9 months ago after taking a hiatus and has come back and come back strong. If you don't know the hashtag Burn Cosmos, you will by the time we finish this podcast. I will go ahead and preface that English is not his first language, so we will definitely work with that throughout the show. He is the current XWF Universal Champion, and he is the man. He is Raion Kiddo, man. What's going on, dude? How are you?
Hello. Everything is okay. How are you? Glad to be here.
You know, me too.
Sorry if that sounded awkward.
No, you're fine, man. I'm glad we were able to set this one up because, you know, again, you're coming down. You're coming to us from South America. One of the beautiful things about the game is being able to talk to people literally from all over the world. And I think you're probably the first from that continent. I could be wrong with year one, but I'm glad we were able to set this up and get this one going because I'm going to go ahead and tell you here and now, your character, when I first saw the first role play come back, this was back when I was staffing with the XWF, I was like, I want to work with him. So that was off of your first piece. So I'm glad that you're back in the game. When did you get started? Tell me about, you know, a little bit about your first character or that you had created.
Okay. I started in 2009, June 2009. It was a Fed that doesn't exist anymore. It's called the Classic Wrestling Federation. And my character was called Mariano Fernandez, which is actually my name. I didn't know I had to make up a name, and I was stupid enough to use my own name. And, well, it was a crash course on the good things and the bad that one learns about the game, because I started with a circle of veteran role players that had known each other for years, if not decades. And I at first didn't know how exactly to cut a promo. I came completely out of nowhere. So it took me some time to understand that I had to theme the promos, and I had to make, more than just a simple message. I started doing like 500 word role plays. I didn't know I had to do at least, 2,000 at a minimum. And it took some time to learn, but I dare say my first year was pretty well. I actually won a minor title. And I had gone against the Fed's top champion, 6 months after I first joined. I lost that match, but it's okay. It was a very nice experience.
Well, I mean, you're coming in off rip, and 6 months in, they're putting you in there with the world champion. That's got to say something. I mean, you got to think the game's changed a lot since 2009 to present
yeah.
day. So
yes, and the things I saw at that time would not be considered acceptable right now. For example, I'm pretty sure I've seen around people talk about kick abortions. I saw that happen in my first year. I never did any of that because that's not what I do. I like hero stories and writing heroes, so that's my specialty. That's what I like to write. And I wouldn't be comfortable writing, gruesome stuff or shock value stuff. That's not really my thing. But I'm used to that, so I kind of got desensitized pretty quick when I saw that. That's why I say it was a crash course.
Oh, for sure. Like, I can only imagine, Well, let me backtrack for just a second. When you came back in 2009, when you first came into the game in 2009, what made you want to come into the game? I mean, were you a wrestling fan growing up, or did you just say, huh, let me just see if there's, you know, e-fetting or internet wrestling out there? What was your driving, what drove you to get into the game?
I came completely by accident. I was looking for something else. Growing up, I watched wrestling, but in my country, wrestling is not like the industry it is on United, in the United States and Europe. We know what wrestling is. We've had some legendary companies, but it was more like a version of a poor man's version of the golden days of the WWF and the territories, like silly gimmicks, geared mostly towards infants, towards young kids, not even teenagers. So it was a shock to me when I was in my teens and I saw that the WWE started showing in my country, and I saw this is a complete different thing from what I'm used to. In any case, I know I gotta talk about how I got into e-fetting.
Mm-hmm.
I was a wrestling fan mostly through video games, because I had grown up with some wrestling video games, like say Royal Rumble for the Super Nintendo.
Sure.
Or No Mercy on the 64. That's probably that's probably the best wrestling game ever made.
I was literally about to say, is that not the best fucking wrestling game that they've ever come up with and they've ever made? I agree, hands down.
That company, Aki, did everything. Not only No Mercy, there was also WrestleMania 2000. There was also WCW versus NWO. And there was Virtua Pro Wrestling 2 in Japan. But in any case, I came in contact with these games through emulation. And people do crazy shit with emulation. They, for example, today they modify No Mercy to look like NXT, for example, like WWE NXT, mm-hmm. or actual rosters. Sorry, current rosters. And that's what I was looking for when I started searching around in Google for No Mercy mods, as they call them. And I stumbled upon this forum that had this effect going. I joined mostly to talk about wrestling, but at one point I made a thread asking, if you were an actual wrestler, what would be your gimmick? What would you do? And somebody told me, join this eFed. It's exactly what you want to do. You just have to write it. And that's how I joined.
It's complete happy stance, man. Like, that's just, it's unbelievable to see that even back then, way before Twitter was a thing, way before the internet was a thing, basically you're on a message board, man, you come over here and check this out. This is what you're looking for. All right.
It was an e-fed that was contained in a forum, and it was just the forum and the e-fed. I didn't know there was a whole world of e-feds out there.
Like, a whole new world. Has just opened up before you, and you don't even know it. And it's only thriving in certain areas here, in certain areas there. So you come in, all right? We got your descript on your entrance, complete by luck. When you came into the earlier years, you're talking about writing the 500 word role plays before working your way up to the, you know, several thousand word role plays, and you said that you were able to pick up, one of the underneath championships in your first year. Talk to me about that. How did that make you feel, knowing that, you know, not even, you know, a year into this game, you're picking up a championship, and you start out with 500 words.
It was great to see that people recognized that I have some writing ability in a language that isn't my own. I'm a native Spanish speaker, so writing in English isn't particularly difficult for me, but creatively writing, it was a challenge, because there is a completely different culture in wrestling from English to Spanish. For example, I don't know if a role play I would make in English would sound as good as I think it does in my own language. That's something that mystifies me to this day. But in any case, it was great to see that people saw that I could write, that I had some ability, and that they were interested in seeing my character succeed, especially since, like I said, I play faces and there's nothing better for a face than people to root for him.
First of all, we're not going to gloss over the fact that you just said that, you know, again, speaking and writing in English is not your forte and your first language. So, you know, anyone that does that, I know there's several people out there that do have to do that. Shout out, because I can't write in another language. So the fact that not only did you come and play the game, you have to figure out how to get your shit across from that language barrier, writing and putting it, you know, actually thinking about it and then translating it and then putting it on paper. So let's not pretend
now,
like that's
I
not
just directly think in English right now.
Oh, yeah.
When I have to write, I simply think in English. I can't think in Spanish.
Well, when you pick up the championship, you got the belt. So let's go through some of your earlier successes. As you're growing as a character, how long did you stick around with the original character?
Okay, the original character, like I said, I started in 2009 and I went on a hiatus in about 2011. The original Fed shut down, but some handlers created another Fed out of the ashes, let's say, and I came there, I became top champion. I held the title for about, I don't know, maybe 3 months. And when I lost it, I said, okay, the Fed is healthy. It's in a better place than it was when we first started. We had a huge war with some group of handlers that they were kind of basically like the clique in the old WWF. They played that and they saw themselves as that. But the newer handlers that started in that place that shut down. I was one of them, but there were some others more. We took the reins and I beat the champion back then. I became the champion. In that time, the Fed grew. Plenty of new people came. And when I left, it was in a much better place than it was when it began. So that's when I decided I had enough. I could retire in peace, although the other people still hated me. And we had several years of a Cold War, let's say. They commented in social media, Facebook at the time, about how I had screwed them and whatever. But fast forward to 2015, this circle of people start an EFED again. And someone of those people contacted me to come back. They didn't want me there, but I came back incognito. Mm-hmm. It was the same character wearing a mask under a completely different name and a completely different gimmick, because the character of Mariano Fernandez was a hero. A very serious hero that spoke not very differently from Raion about justice and about honor and all of that. And then I put him in a mask and I devised a new gimmick. I call him the troll guy. Like, you know, Scott Hall saying, say hello to the bad guy. In this case, it was say hello to the troll guy. And he was ridiculous on Twitter. He was using you know, the old problem meme and those rage faces, they call them, those very badly drawn cartoon faces. Mm-hmm. My gimmick was that. And I came to that place. It was called Next Gen Promotions in 2015. And again, first I won a minor title, and eventually I made it to the top. I became top champion. Unfortunately, the Fed shut down after that because the owner disappeared. I don't know where he went to this day. But it was fine that all the conflicts I have had in the past were peacefully solved, and everybody celebrated when I became champion. Those wounds were closed, those matters were put to rest. This place, NGW, started advertising on Twitter, and that's how I came into contact with Jason Cash. I became friends with Jason Cash, who was then in a place called 4CW, Four Corners Wrestling. So in 2016, I joined 4CW, and I stayed there for about 4 years until it shut down in January 2020, or February 2020, I can't well remember. But I stayed there 3 years, something else, almost 4 years. And that's how my previous character came to be big. He's inactive now, but he has 2,000 followers on Twitter. So he was no joke, even though some people there still think he is.
Credit Jason Cash. It's
a bittersweet time. Sorry. Sorry I cut in.
No, absolutely. Go ahead. You continue.
I was going to say it's a very bittersweet time because I became top champion of 4CW2 in September 2018. But then I lost the title in the rematch. And that was perhaps my greatest failure, because during the first year I joined 4CW, my character was made out to be a joke, not by the staff or not by the handler, but by some people that are still active to this day, and they are a tightly knit group of people that like, I don't know, they like role playing hard, but they fail to realize that there's someone else behind the screen. And sometimes they turn out of character stuff into in character. Sometimes they cut in on someone's interactions on Twitter. That's what they did to me constantly. For 4 years, I endured that. I was going to say, I did fairly well in 4CW because not only did I become top champion, I also became a triple crown champion. I had won the tag team titles with someone else in a tournament, and then I lost. Then I won a minor title, and then I lost that title to a character called Cartier, a very sassy black woman. She's hilarious. And then I won it back in New Year of 2020. And then I lost the champion showcase match against the top champion then, and then the Fed shut down.
And then vacation began.
Not only was I in 4CW, I was in plenty of feds. Many angle feds contacted me to work with them. Such is the case, for example, with mainstream wrestling, which is still active. Most of them shut down, but I was in, like, I don't know, maybe 7, 8 feds at one point. At one point, my character had like 7 titles. It was crazy.
You were pulling a Chris Page before Chris Page was.
No, but they weren't top titles. They were minor titles, like say, tag team titles or secondary titles. The times I've been a world champion were like 3 times with my character. I count 3 world titles. No. I know that people may have 10 or 20 or maybe 30 world titles, but I haven't been in the game for that long. And I haven't been in many feds for that long. And I think I have a fair measure of talent, but I don't know if I could pull something like that off. I'm I'm happy enough with more than any title or any recognition by having my characters be respected, because I suffered that for a long time. So it was great for me to see that when I came to the XWF, Raion was respected almost from day one. And that was a very welcome change, and I'm very grateful for that.
I'll tell you this. So, and I've told Jason Cash this, and I've told Vinny this as well. I credit Jason Cash for bringing you back again, getting you back into the game. Like I said that earlier on the show. And every time I talk to him, I'm like, I always say thank you for Kiddo. and obviously you were with him in your prior Fed. I think he reached out to you, and then Vinny reached out to you, and you came back. And off rip, like you've literally been on this excuse me, on this rise.
No problem.
All year long. It's been incredible to sit back and watch.
I'm very grateful that has happened, and that people saw me as a worthy contender, and I'm very grateful that I could win the title. I wasn't expecting that, and I recall you saying that if Dolly Waters had not posted a third one, maybe she would be wearing that belt, and I completely agree, because everyone in there, Charlie Nichols, Dolly Waters, Alias himself, they are monsters, quite literally. And I'm saying this as a compliment, because they are very good handlers. And my brain was bleeding every time I wrote against them, I ended up feeling like my brain was bleeding, like I had an internal bleeding in my head.
Mm-hmm. Well, I've been in there with Dolly, not as Dolly, as R.L. Edgar. I've been in there with Charlie. I've been in there with who was the? You were the third. I haven't been in there with you yet.
I hope I am worthy of that opinion once it's over.
Oh yeah, we're gonna get there, bud, because that's definitely some future shit. I would say this: like you came back into the XWF, and I think it was like January ish. You've kind of had this on again, off again deal with Charlie Nichols, and I think Charlie knocked you off, and you picked up. Wait a minute, how many times have you and Charlie hooked up?
Twice.
Twice.
The first time was a television title match, and then there was the Star Warfare. It was a triple threat match. It was Raion, it was Charlie, and it was Michael McBride.
Right on, right on. So there's this little unspoken rivalry with Charlie. What do you think about that?
Yeah, he really pushed me hard the first time. I thought I would win the television title, but then he proved quickly why he deserved to be television champion. It was a humbling experience. And I hope that we eventually do this again, and I hope that if or when it does, I am up to the task, because there is still a one-on-one victory he has over me. I recall I have won the title in a match where he was, but it was a four-way match, not a one-on-one.
Excuse me. Yeah, for sure. You guys, when you talk about, obviously the culmination so far of your year has been the Universal Championship and picking that up. And you guys did that at the Cannabis Cup, which I'm very gracious to have all four of you competing in what was looked at as probably one of the matches of the entire weekend.
It was a wonderful event.
It was a busy event, and there was a lot of moving parts with that event. But at the end of the day, that's where you're crowned as the Universal Champion. And coincidentally, on the same night that you're crowned as the Uni Champ, Mark Flynn wins the Cannabis Cup and has now set you guys up on this crash course for what is the XWF's biggest pay-per-view of the year next weekend, next Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. It's Relentless, and it's headlined by your defending, as Raion Kiddo, defending the Universal Championship against Mark Flynn.
Exactly. And it's going to be a great match because I know Mark Flynn gave me trouble when I won the Leap of Faith match. He was one of the hardest people with which I've had to compete for that particular event.
For sure. And, you know, that's something else that we didn't even touch on. As a character, you not only do you have the uni, you also have the briefcase. You have a briefcase, which guarantees you a shot at any point in time. So even if somebody knocks you off, right now your character is like a double threat. Can turn right back around and cash in a briefcase and take that son of a bitch right back.
And I'm just going to make a joke here. He has the briefcase and he defended his title, which should grant a rematch by default.
Well, if you lose...
I'm not going to do it then. Don't worry.
If you lose the title via cash-in, I think over there you get a rematch. If you don't lose it via cash-in, then you don't get a rematch.
No, don't worry. Don't worry. That's not really important. I'm just happy that Raion became the champion and that he defended it once. Whatever happens after that happens.
Well, you've got, with that briefcase, man, I don't even see Raion using it as a... as a tool. Like, I see the way that character is, he would probably come out and announce his match well in advance as the white meat babyface that he is.
Probably.
Well, how much fun actually, are you having now?
Oh, no. Now I'm having a great time. Not only do I not have to prove myself anymore, because I spent 4 years trying to prove myself and it was an impossible task. But now I think I have proven myself and I'm in a place where people recognize who I am and what I do. And I've been having dream matches. For example, tonight is Saturday Night Savage and I'm going against Tatara Femis. She was one of the reasons, among many others, for which I decided to come to the XWF. With my earlier character, I was aware of Atara, I was aware of James Raven, I was aware of Betsy Granger. We had some friendly rapport, but we hadn't even worked together or weren't even in the same circles. So that's one of those three people, for example, are some of the reasons for which I've come to the XWF. And I'm very glad that Raion and Atara are having this match tonight.
I do too. I think that Atara is one of the few handlers that I think I've missed working with, as far as in a match. But I always say that she's one of the most unsung heroes of the game. There's a lot that she does that most people will never know about, and it's just it's good to see. Anytime she can come back and do something anywhere, I think is fun. And to know that she's getting to do something with you, it made it a little bit more appealing and a lot more entertaining. Because I believe it's her first match back after giving birth, if I'm not mistaken.
Yes. It's the first match since she became a wife and a mother.
Oh, man. I bet Kiddo's going to be conflicted about that one.
His roleplay shows that. I think Atara made a great job of showing that too. So I won't be surprised if she wins.
Let's talk a little bit about, obviously, you've got Mark Flynn, who you said is one of your biggest, as far as the Leap of Faith match was probably the toughest competition. I think he and you two both are probably two writers, like word for word, that have had almost mirror image years of success. And I'm loving the fact that you guys are going to be writing against each other at the biggest pay-per-view of the XWF's, in the XWF's world, with the Universal Championship on the line. Because there's just a lot that can happen there. And I think that your character is in a position to where, like, he could almost work with anybody.
I hope so, but like I said, if Flynn beats me, he will have done so well, and I'm pretty satisfied of with how my role here has been. If I win, I win. If I lose, I lose. I will just try to have fun.
No doubt. Speaking of fun, coming up in the future, are you doing Terra Phoenix's charity cruise?
I'm sorry, I didn't get that.
Okay. There was a super show in November.
Yes. The World Series of Wrestling. Yes, I'm doing that.
That's it. Okay, so let's pivot there. So World Series of Wrestling. I thought maybe you were doing Terra show, but World Series of Wrestling is coming up for you. Tell me what you think about that.
I was also going to do the Night of the Main Events that the Casino Kid Justin York was putting together, but I didn't hear anything about that. So I don't know if that's still on.
It depends on who you ask. Apparently, if you ask him, I sabotaged his show, but he can't show anywhere where I did that. But I don't know. I'm not partaking in the program.
For the moment, then, it's the World Series of Wrestling.
Well, what do you got going on there? You enjoying that little experience?
Well, it's going to be great. It's going to be hard if I make it to the 7,000 round, but so far I have done the. I have put my application there. TIA Promotions had said it's good, and maybe tomorrow I will do the other segment, the 750 introductory vignette. I haven't begun work on that yet, but I will tomorrow. I just want to know how far I can go. I don't know if I'm going to be the winner or, you know, the best ever e-fetter to grace the game, because that's really not my goal. I'm just happy with doing fairly well, and mostly with having the rest of the world recognize that I am able to do good things. You know, that's my entire intention. I want everyone that works with me to live happy. That's the only thing I really want.
When it comes down to the World Series of Wrestling, first of all, shout out to Tim Applesauce, co-host of Ring Bell Radio. I was initially like not necessarily 100% sure of the concept. So he gave me the golden ticket a while back. It was like, you can just, you know, give it to anybody. And I went to John Cable because this is like right up John's alley. Go ahead.
I would like to give him a shout out of my own to Team Applesauce, because when he handed the ticket to the XWF, he was hoping, he told me, that I would be picked. And he said, if they hadn't chosen you, I would have handed you a ticket myself.
Mm-hmm.
And that was very nice to hear. So shout out to him from me.
Yeah, no doubt. He's really got this concept down. And now I'm kind of feeling like I missed the boat. It's just one of those situations. But he's going to be working hard to put together this. This is an interesting little spin on what would be considered a super show. And it's not necessarily a show. This takes place over months for this to culminate. I don't think it finishes up until Christmas time. What was that?
I'm bracing for a hard October. It's going to be very difficult.
It should be fun, though. It's going to be interesting to see what everybody comes up with. I'm going to be looking at the work. I know that. And I, not to get too far ahead, but one of my little dream matches, if you will, of people that I've been trying to check off my bucket list because I'm on my way out, was working with you. And running CCPE in character, we fall under, a lot of swords. and a lot of bullets fly our way. So I got tired of hearing people talking about shit, and I threw out that challenge for CCPE versus the world. And we've already put together pretty much the card's pretty much done. It came together so quick. But one of the people that I reached out to initially and first was you, so I could write against you for the first time. And I'm
I will do
super.
my best to be worthy of that.
I am
For
so
me,
looking forward to it. You have no idea, dude. I don't get excited about much anymore when it comes to in the game, because I've kind of done what I wanted to do, how I've wanted to do it for the last 20 years that I've been in the game. And so just it's been there, done that. It's kind of the synopsis. But I haven't been in the ring with your character. I know that your character is the epitome of what a fucking face should be. So I'm going to be the epitome of what a heel should be, and tell a story. I'm looking forward to telling the story up until the match, because if you think that it's just you and I are hooking up on like the 26th or whatever of January without some kind of build behind it, you're mistaken. We're
I
gonna
know, I
we
know.
got we got.
I thought I was expecting that.
Oh yeah, we're gonna talk, because I got something in my head story wise that I think would be fucking great, and to get your spin on it and get your take on it will be even better. That's how you tell the best
I
stories.
promise I'm easy to work with.
I am too, because I don't give a fuck about winning or losing. All I care about is I'll care about the story. Did the story, it wasn't talked about. Did people look at it as being good, or was it terrible? But there's just so much to do. You again, the characters will tell that story. I'm looking forward to it. I'll just tell you that. I'm looking forward to it.
So am I.
I mean, what are you looking forward to next? I mean, obviously you've got all this stuff kind of happening in front of you. You've got some pretty big, big things shaking. Universal Championship scene, that's like the Shark Tank. I know that that's one of those situations of when it goes, it goes. But I know how you feel about getting that first defense in. It took me like 2 years to get to the championship once I came back to the XWF, and it was the thrill was getting to the belt, winning the belt, and then defending the belt. And then it's just like, all right, what's next? Have you made it to that point yet, or are you still kind of like on that high of, oh shit, I'm still the Universal Champion?
I think I'm still on that. Oh shit, I'm the Universal Champion high. But like I said, I would really like to win because I'm given to understand that something will happen if I win, or something may happen if I win. You gotta check that with Vinny Lane. But that's all I feel I can say. But if I lose, it will be no problem. I'll just dedicate to whatever the road takes me. I'm just glad Raion had this astronomic rise because I never saw this coming. You gotta understand that this is a character based on a literal anime show from the 80s, like very much like Liger was in Japan. And the fact that something like this I made was successful, I'm already over the moon. Like, what can I say? I just gotta have fun. It's the only thing I really think about.
That's the only thing you can do at this point. Like, is just enjoy the ride. Enjoy it while you're there.
But like I said, I would sometime in the future, I don't know, maybe 1, 2 years from now, or I don't know, whenever it happens, I would like to face the names that I have said. For example, I would like to face Betsy Granger or James Raven if he comes back to the XWF. I had a great time writing with Centurion, so I would like to work with him again. Dream matches. For me, it's about dream matches now.
I hear you. I hear you. And I'm sure that some of those dream matches we can make happen somewhere. Don't know if you knew this or not, but Denzel Porter, myself, and TIA Promotions, and Tier Phoenix.
Shout out to Denzel too, because he also followed me from the beginning, and he's a blessing to the community.
Hey, no doubt. Talk to that guy just about every day throughout the week. We've all kind of pulled our resources together to start doing the quarterly super shows and stuff of that nature. So knowing that I'm helping book some of that stuff, I'm pretty sure I can convince those dream matches and make them happen over the course of 2023.
I hope so.
That's a simple thing. So, I'm sure by the time they listen to this podcast, they're going to be like, well, why didn't you just ask? Be like, no, I wanted you to tell me because then I knew you listened to the show. That's how I troll Raven.
Well, I try to be humble. I don't mean to brag. That's not something I do. I just try to keep a humble approach because, like I said, I'm just a guy from Argentina doing a writing show online. I'm really nobody, and I'm nobody special inside IFED either. I'm just a guy that plays heroes and takes like already existing things, like I did with Raion, or like I did with my other character, which was mostly about video games, because I'm a huge video game fan, and people know me for that. And I take these things and I just tell them in the way I would like to tell them. I try to make these things my own. And like I said, I'm nobody, so I don't feel like I have a right to ask anything. I would rather earn the success and the respect I can get.
Well, you've already gotten mine, dude. I've been there by the character since you came back, and was just happy to have been able to see how this thing has materialized for you, because you've done such a tremendous job writing as Raion Kiddo, and I don't know what else to say about it, man. Like, you know, to see that you've come so far so quick. You came back in January. You've already won the Universal Championship. You're getting ready to headline the biggest pay-per-view of the XWF's calendar year, and you already have some pretty big shit lined up. Coming down the pipe. And it's incredible when you really sit back and think about it.
Yeah, it really is. And like I keep saying that, but at the end of the day, I'm just a role player like everybody else. I'm just another guy, and I try to make my work count. That's why I try to have the best work ethic I can. And I'm glad that it has produced some fantastic results.
For sure.
That's all I can say. That's all I can say for myself.
Before we tie bow on this one, I always usually ask all my guests, I've been talking to you and yakking your ear off about your career for the last about an hour, give or take. You have any questions for me? This is an opportunity to ask me anything.
Let's see. How do you feel about having been in the game for so long? You said you were on your way out. How would you like that ending to be? Let's say, what will make you, when you finally step down, what will make you say, I've done all this and I am happy and I can look back and just leave it behind? I can look back fondly, but I know my time is done.
Well, I already have my exit kind of worked out. So, it's just a matter of getting there as far as Chris Page is concerned. I won't be quitting the game by any means, but I'll be retiring, the character.
That's what I wanted to do with my other character, but then shit happened.
Yeah, I still got, I mean, let me just say this. Retiring as Chris Page is probably a word that probably shouldn't be said, because chances are I would still do, one-offs at super shows here and super shows there anyway for the next couple of years. But as far as, like, actively going and, dancing around and playing around and all the different waters, that's coming to an end for sure. But it's there. I know what I want to do. I already have it mapped out. I've already talked to the person that I want to do it with too. So, like, whenever I hit them up and I'll be like, yo, I'm ready. They'll be like, all right, let's go.
And I hope it works the best way possible.
It's gonna be a pretty lengthy story, but it's gonna be one that's gonna have a pretty good payoff, I think. And I think it'll it's gonna put it's gonna put somebody well, well, I can't say that out loud, but I was gonna say it's gonna put somebody over. But no, it's gonna be fun. The story's already the seeds have already been planted, but we're still a ways away from that. I've got while you're on the verge of Relentless, I'm also current I'm in current cycle of IIW, where I'll be wrestling for their world title. So this is my first. I'm in my cycle right now. This will be my first championship opportunity since I lost the very belt that you hold right now.
I see. I hope that also goes well.
If it does, I've already figured out how I'm gonna tie it into the story that you and I try and do too. It's gonna be great. I think you're gonna love it. I'm gonna really fucking be like, it's because of you that inspired me to get back to the promised land.
Looking forward to seeing it.
Excuse me, you got anything else you wanna ask?
No, I think everything has been very detailed. We have covered everything I really wanted to cover. And I'm sorry if I've been annoying or or I've took too long to say something. I just make things up as I go.
Dude, you've not been annoying, and don't ever apologize for being you, man. Like you weren't annoying me at all. Remember, English is not your first fucking language, dude. I think that we had a pretty good show. I was really glad to get this one in and get you tracked down. I appreciate you taking the time, because again, you're down in South America. This has been fun. You have anything that you want to say to the listeners before we close it out?
Thank you very much for listening to me, for giving me the chance to make my thoughts known to the EFED community. And I hope that if I don't know you, that we eventually get to work together and that you will get a good impression of me. And to those that have a bad impression of me, I want to say, I'm sorry.
Couldn't say it better. This has been CCP Podcasting Productions. I am Chris Page. Next week on the program, I believe we've got Big Money Ozzy coming in next week. At the end of the day, folks, hope you have a good weekend, and we will chat again.